Hello and welcome to Nikolai's Genetics Lessons. And today's problem is DNA molecule has base ratio of adenine and guanine to cytosine and thymine as 1.0. Testing of this base composition indicates that the cytosine content is 19%. What is the thymine content of this double-stranded DNA? And now imagine that here is a single-stranded DNA and we have sequence as follows: adenine, 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 guanine, guanine, cytosine, cytosine, and cytosine. As you see, we don't have thymines here at all, and that means that ratio between these bases can be different. And according to the Chargaff's rule, cytosine always base pair with guanine, and thymine always base pairs with adenine. And in single-stranded DNA, we are never going to get a ratio of adenine and guanine to cytosine and thymine as 1.0. It can be anything. So as you see, we have, for example, here three adenines and no thymines at all. We have two guanines and three cytosines. But if we will also draw corresponding strand of the DNA that is going to be complementary, adenine would base pair with thymine, guanine with cytosine, and cytosine with guanines. Now let's count. We have, let me underline, 1, 2, 3 adenines. So we have three adenines here. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 guanines. So 5 guanines. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cytosines. And we also have 1, 2, 3 thymines. And as you see, this is exactly what we predict with Chargaff's rule, that if we know number of thymines, we instantly know number of adenines, because in double-stranded DNA, thymine base pairs with adenine. And if we know number of guanines or cytosines in double-stranded DNA, we instantly know corresponding nucleic acid base. And now let's return to our problem. We are told that we have cytosine content as 19%. We can use absolute numbers as in our example, or we can use percentages here. So if cytosine would be 19%, then guanine also going to be 19%. 19% plus 19% would give us 38%. We know that our double-stranded DNA, 38% cytosine and guanine. That give us information that the rest two bases would make another 62%. And this also means that 31% would be thymine and 31% would be adenine. So our question: what is the thymine content of the DNA? And here is going to be our answer, 31%. Now let's check our formula here. Adenine plus guanine, so adenine plus guanine, and here is the numbers. Once again, adenine plus guanine, which is 31% plus 19%, divided by cytosine plus thymine. Cytosine is 19%, as you see, and thymine 31%. So 19% plus 31%. And this basically means that we have to divide 50 by 50. And we are going to get 1. So, whenever we get 1, this means that this double-stranded DNA were cytosine with pair with guanine and thymine with pairs with adenine. So, if we are going to get any other number than 1, that means that we have single-stranded DNA where ratios of these bases can be any, and we even can miss, like in this example, one of the bases completely, like we miss here thymine, and here we miss adenine. So even if we know only percentage content of only single base, it can be any base, we instantly know that corresponding base, that this base would base pair would be the same percentage, and then we would know how many percent would be made by other two bases. So if we know adenine, we can find all the rest bases DNA content in the double-stranded DNA, the same with cytosine, guanine and thymine, and one base would be enough in order to find DNA content for all four bases. And this is all for today. Thank you for your attention. Please subscribe for my new videos that I post almost every day. Thumbs up if you like this video. Please write your comments, questions if you have any. Share this video with your classmates. And see you in the next video. Goodbye.